What's going on, everybody? This is Kat and I'm back with a new video. I just started my journey here, so for the newcomers, Primal VFX is the place where we learn about visual effects, CG, and much more. So today we will discover 5 ways with 5 different softwares on how to convert your texture maps into normal maps. Tools that I've discovered recently and others that I've used for many years. So get relaxed, grab a coffee or a cup of tea, and let's roll the intro!
So guys, the first tool is XNormal. It's completely free and it's the OG tool for making maps. Look at this interface. It recalls me some good old memories. You may ask, why I show you this piece of history? The reason is very simple. Many times, this software saved me. When modern bakers failed, XNormal can save you a lot of pain. It also contains really useful Photoshop plugins. We can convert maps into normal maps in few clicks. So first off, convert your image into a grayscale image. Then go to Filter, XNormal, and click on Add to Normal button. We've got a series of options, and just hit the Continue button. A really quick and simple way to do conversion in Photoshop. The second one is Knald. Knald was groundbreaking at its time. A standalone ultra-fast GPU solution for generating and converting maps. It is still useful and relevant today. So, with our 4K tileable texture, we can load it inside. So go to the menu and click Load Color Map. Boom, you've got a real-time preview of the result at the left, and on the right the normal map preview. We can adjust the iteration, the intensity, something like 50% will do for this texture. We can also invert the normal and tweak the level of details per scale. Then just click on Update. Okay, now it's updated. You now also have access to the other useful maps generated from the single color map. You can set up your export maps going onto the Export tab. Choose different depth bits and extensions. To export only the normal map, deselect everything. Let's choose EXR format and 32 bits. Now we can specify the output folder. Then at last, go back to the main tab and click on Export. The third one is Shader Map. I just discovered it and it seems really interesting. First, verify your input map type. Let's select our color map. Now it will automatically generate all the maps. You've got also a nice preview system. You can change the orientation of the lights. On every map generated, you've got a bunch of settings to tweak. So, on the normal map, you can adjust the intensity and tweak the details. A sharpen effect can be also added. I admit, it looks really promising. If we right-click on the normal map, we can export it. Nice to see that Shader Map also has a large range of formats and bit depth. The fourth one is the mighty Substance Designer, the power of procedural creation with ease. So first off, go to Edit and create a new substance. Choose PBR Metallic Roughness Template. Input a name. For size mode, you can keep relative to parent mode. Now, we can switch our size document to 4K as the input texture is in 4K. Now we have all the output maps created for us. We will focus on the normal map output. Let's import the wood texture into Substance Designer. We can either link or import the resource file. Let's link it like this. If we update it later, it will automatically update it in Substance Designer. Okay, now we need to convert it to a grayscale map. So click on Tab and let's pick the grayscale conversion node. Let's plug it like this. Then again, press Tab and let's search for the normal node. Let's plug it again. Okay, so the normal is really too heavy. Be sure to check the Force Alpha to 1 button. We can modify the intensity. Better, but not quite right. Let's add a level node to control the normal output. Let's plug it in the middle. Okay. Now we can tweak the value to have a better result. It's the same as in the other software. By changing the height and the midpoint of the luminance, we are increasing or decreasing the level of details. Okay, nice. Then we just need to plug it to the normal output. To export the normal map, just go to the left and right click on the name package. Select Export Outputs. Substance Designer also has a large range of formats. Select the destination, deselect everything apart normal and click on Export Outputs. Okay, just a quick tip now. A friend of mine asked me if it's possible to convert normal maps into displacement in Substance Designer. Okay, to do so, create a normal to 8 node and just plug it like this. You can tweak the value in V node to match your desired result. You can also add a sharpened node to make it more crisp if you want. The fifth one is Normalizer. It's a simple but powerful tool for texture manipulation and conversion, available for free, but still in beta. It will convert 8 maps to normal maps and normal maps to 8 maps. No color map allowed, so be aware of that. Let's pick our 8 map, then click on 8 map to normal. We can put a low value for the intensity, like 0.1, enable the supersampling method for better results. Boom, done, really straightforward. We can go to the menu, File, and then Save As. Normalizer only have PNG and TIFF format. No EXR format right now. I hope that in the official release it will be present.
Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the content, you know what to do. Subscribe to my channel for more awesomeness. And I see you guys in the next video.